is dedicated to my hilarious and caring mother. Thank you for giving me so much unconditional love and for giving me your fat arms and wonky eye. So there's actually a lot of chapters to this, so we're gonna go one at a time. So this is going to be the first chapter, an introduction. Hi, I'm Shane Dawson. Some of you might know me from my videos on the internet. Some of you might know me from the movie I directed entitled Not Cool. And some of you might know me as the guy you saw on the cover of this book, who has an incredibly punchable face. I'm all those things and more. I always have an incredibly punchable body. No, I also have. Society. If I could spend my entire life underneath a heating blanket with a handful of my own balls, I would happily do so. I'm not saying that I don't like the stuff I put out into the world, because I generally enjoy my videos and think they're funny. What I'm saying is that I embrace the fact that I have a punchable face, and that if I could punch myself without feeling it, I would. Sometimes I scroll through my Instagram page and audibly groan. What is the point of posting 4 pictures a day of yourself doing the same duck face in 4 different locations? If you go through my Instagram feed, it's like a flipbook of me thinking I'm way more attractive than I am. It's nauseating, but feel free to follow me @ Shane Dawson! ! I feel like that exclamation point is important. Should I go to the doctor? Never mind. Just gonna Google it. And ugh. Is Emma Stone still a thing? Can that be over yet? It gets really deep. I'm a social warrior, clearly. In this book, you'll get to see the real me, not the me you see on YouTube. You will get to know what's really in my head. And I'm warning you, it's not pretty. It's a twisted land of self-hatred, sadness, and lots of repressed anger toward every person who's ever hurt me. Enjoy, don't worry. I threw in some dick and fart jokes to make the stories a little easier to handle. Kind of like mixing in some peanut butter with your medicine, which, by the way, my mom used to do. You haven't lived until you've had a Vicodin peanut butter marshmallow fluff sandwich. I can still taste the numbing of my emotions. Delicious. I urge you to sit back, enjoy, and know that in the end, things have gotten better for me, and they will for you too. If that's anything you're worried about, feel free to laugh at my misfortune and get that feeling of, wow, my life is so much better than that guy's. My destiny. Nothing gives me more anxiety than getting a haircut. Just the thought of going to a salon, I mean barber, and having a stranger touch my head while asking me personal questions about my life makes my nerves shoot through the roof. It's the same feeling a wicker chair gets when a circa 2006 Kelly Clarkson takes a seat. Tense. But sometimes you have to bite the bullet and let Kelly Clarkson sit on your face. The day after my high school graduation was one of those times. I had rocked the same shoulder-length frizzy do since I was 12 years old, and the style had run its course. Frizzy do. I got it. I got you now. Hair. There was only so much I could do with it. Actually, there were only 3 things I could do with it. Wash it, let it air dry, and pray to God I didn't get lice. Gross. My hair was lice's dream habitat. The amount of poof and waves made it practically a tropical getaway for those little buggers. I'm sure every time I walked by a homeless dude, his lice would only wish they were having an adventure in my twisted, knotted labyrinth of a hairdo. I might not have had girls double-taking when I walked by, but darn it, the lice wanted a mother trucking piece. So one hot Monday afternoon in June of 2006, I pulled into a shopping center parking lot and stared at the Supercut sign that was casting a shadow. This was the day I had prepared myself for this moment for weeks, and I was ready. I took a deep breath, took a bite of protein cookie, which, let's face it, was just a cookie, and stumbled through the door with fear in my eyes. The woman at the register looked up at me with a welcoming smile and asked what she could do for me. I asked for a haircut. She paused, awkward silence, then she said, "Woman or men's?" Yep, it was definitely time for a haircut. She walked me over to the station and looked around, scoping out what the situation was. The situation was pretty clear. These people had no freaking idea what they were doing, and it smelled like El Polo Loco had farted and locked the doors for 2 weeks. I was too lazy to find another salon, barber, so I just sat in a stained purple swivel chair and awaited my fate. "Receptionist, Destiny will be with you soon. She's in the back talking to her ex-husband on the phone." Me, definitely didn't need all that information, but thank you. So I sat and flipped through a Spanish version of People magazine from 15 years ago, thinking, wow, I don't know who this Selena chick is, but she's definitely going places. As I skimmed through the magazine, my Razer phone started vibrating, playing Ashley Simpson's Pieces of Me. It was my mom calling. "Hey, Mom. Did you do it yet?" "No, still waiting. I think my stylist is in the middle of a custody battle right now." Okay, this is between him and his mom, just so you know. So the mom goes, "Oh, fun. Are you excited?" And Jane goes, "Not really. I'm scared she's going to make me look like a troll doll." Mom, "Aw, but you're my little troll doll." Shane, "Not really the response I was looking for, but thanks, Mom." "Mom, well, call me when you're done and email me a picture on your pager." What? So Shane says, "That makes no sense. Mom says, love you." Yep, that didn't make sense. As I reached for another decade-old magazine, my stylist walked up to greet me. I put stylist in quotes because her cosmetology certificate looked like it was printed on the back of a Denny's placemat. My expectations for this haircut were about the same as when I walk into an Eddie Murphy movie. I know it's going to be bad, but maybe it will give people a few laughs. I like to spread joy, even if it's at my expense. I looked her up and down, and my expectations went from an Eddie Murphy movie to an Adam Sandler film made after 2008. The situation was grown-ups bad. It looked like she had cut her hair without scissors and had instead chosen to cover her head in peanut butter and raw meat and hang upside down from a tree branch in a dog park. She was wearing one of those crappy Halloween shirts that said, "This is my costume." Did I mention it was June? She had hoop earrings so big I could have inked myself with them, which I thought would come in handy if the haircut went horribly, as I suspected it would. She took a sip of the world's biggest Starbucks Frappuccino and let out a small, uncontainable burp. This was going great. "Destiny, so what do you want?" "For you to tell me that you are just another sassy front desk person and Destiny's still in the back screaming at her baby daddy."
"Nope, I'm your Destiny."
"That pun is particularly terrifying. I'm going to use the restroom. I'll be right back." At that moment, I wished I was in a horror film, because "I'll be right back" usually means you aren't going to be back. You're going to die. I wished I was dead. Now, I know what you're thinking. Why didn't I just leave? Because I have a syndrome called no balls disorder. That's why. Basically, I have no freaking balls, and I say yes to everything to avoid conflict. I've gotten better at it with age, but at this time I was 18 and terrified of everything and everyone around me, including wicker furniture. I went into the bathroom and locked the door. I stood in the front of the mirror and looked at myself. I tried to make myself see something that wasn't there. A great hairstyle, maybe. If I could convince myself that my hair looked okay the way it was, I could just get out of there and never get a haircut again. Yeah, that seemed doable. I took out my phone and started taking hundreds of selfies. Different angles, different faces, lots of filters. I was trying my hardest to find at least one picture where I felt like I didn't look completely unattractive. It didn't happen. It made it worse. After the bathroom photo shoot, I decided it was time to go back out there and face my destiny. "Shane, I need help. I'm scared. Can you please make me look like less of a lesbian?" "Destiny, oh, don't be so down on yourself. People shouldn't judge you by your hair or by your lifestyle." She thought I was a woman. Perfect. At this point, I wanted to just shave my freaking head. "Shane, can you just make me look like a guy?" Just Destiny, any specific guy? Did you look through MI magazines, Shane? I don't really think I could pull off Enrique Iglesias from 10 years ago, so maybe just make me look like Brad Pitt. Silence. Challenge not accepted. Out of the realm of possibility. Shane, okay, how about Jay Leno? Destiny. Jay Leno, nobody wants to freak Jay Leno. Shane, my grandmother strongly disagreed, but okay, noted. Destiny, just trust me, I'm gonna just do my thing. Judging from her personal style and the zero customers in line for her, I couldn't imagine her thing being revolutionary, but she was my only hope. She grabbed the scissors and then looked at my head for a moment, put the scissors back down, and replaced them with the biggest set of electric clippers I've ever seen. This wasn't a job for flimsy pieces of metal. This was a job for something that could mow a lawn. I avoided looking at the mirror because I didn't want to see the damage being done. Similar to how when I eat at a restaurant, I keep my eyes clear of any reflective surface. I looked down at my lap and saw chunks of hair gathering near my crotch. The amount of nappy dandruff sprinkled hair that was falling from my head made it look like God was shaving his ancient somethings. It was of biblical proportions. I then heard something that you never want to hear a hairstylist mutter. Destiny says, oops. Oops, oops. You better have spilled some of your Starbucks Frappuccino. Fettuccino about my smock because of the oops is in my way, is in any way related to my haircut. I will one star Yelp you so hard you'll have to change your freaking name and move to Canada. Yelp wasn't really a thing back then, but hey, you get the point. Destiny says, I think I took a little too much off the back. I might have to even it out. Are you okay with that? Am I okay with that? Are you freaking kidding me? You barely jetted GED achieving techie dress snaggle tooth. Wow, no, that this was not okay. Shane, sure. Once again, the no balls disorder. Like any girl having something with the something person, what? I just closed my eyes and waited for it to be over. I heard the sound of clippers turning off and a loud sigh come from the disaster behind me. It was time to see what my head looked like. I opened my eyes and what I saw wasn't a haircut. It was a hair massacre. It was bedhead. If I slept on a bed of starving rats, it was so short I could see my eyebrows, and nobody wanted to see that. Shane says, it's short. Destiny, yep, but it looks super, sexy. I still can't believe she said that without derping. Destiny, you know, there is a way to make it look longer. Shane, nah, I've gotten the email before. Trust me, it's a scam. Destiny, we could always straighten it. Straighten it? What does that mean? How does one straighten? Like one of those creepy Christian camps that weirdo parents and their gay kids do. Shane says, what do you mean? She whips out a large phallic object and turned it on extra high. Destiny says, I'll show you. I wish books could have movie montages. Montages. Because the next 20 minutes were straight out of a 90s Freddie Prinze Jr. movie. I was the ugly girl and Destiny was my slutty sister giving me a makeover. I was going from ugly to not as ugly if you squint your eyes a little. It was a dream come true. After lots of clamping, straightening, and the scent of burnt hair, she was done. I looked in the mirror and actually didn't look that terrible. It was a miracle. Little did she know, she created a monster. From that day forward, I've never met a straightener I didn't destroy with my nappy hair. If it were possible to marry a straightener, I would. I would figure out a way to consummate that marriage. Super gross and slightly dangerous, but I would do it. I went to my car and breathed a huge sigh of relief. I looked at myself in the rearview mirror and stared at the new me. I wasn't the prettiest girl at prom, but I was definitely good enough to get date raped. Bing. My mom texted me asking for a picture of my new look. I opened up my camera and took a picture. I looked at it, and shockingly, I was happy with it.